let's put this on record and let them hear it once again. Dam hai kitna daman mein tere.
Dekh liya hai dekhenge.
Jagah hai kitna jail mein tere.
Dekh liya hai dekhenge.
Okay. So one thing I just wanted to, you know, one of our comrades in jail told me this, you know, analogy. You know, whenever, you know, this workers in a factory, whenever they go on a strike for, let's say, increase of wages, the typical course of action that happens is that, you know, brutal police lathi charge happens, and then some people are severely injured. Okay, some people are picked up, they're arrested, false cases are put on them, and then the entire movement sort of gets diverted into getting them released from the prison, getting medical assistance for them, asking justice on those counts as to why they were beaten up or why they were sacked after that, and why is there a subsequent lockdown of the factory and so on. And we have to understand that the reason why all of these things are done is to divert the actual struggle of raising wages. Right, we in this case in the context of struggle for justice for Rohit Vemmula, and it's not just about Rohit Vemmula, it's about all of us, it's particularly about all the students and all the members of all marginalized communities in this country. What they are trying to do, what they tried to do on the 22nd, was not just an attack on some of us or not just an attack on all of us, it was an attempt to divert the entire movement, and we'll not let that happen. We will fight with the police. We will definitely fight with the police. We have seen what the police is capable of. So far, we had seen what the police is capable of when we looked at Kashmir, when we looked at Northeast, when we looked at Bastar. On 22nd, we saw what the police is capable of. Here, in the heart of Hyderabad, in a so-called central university. And we are not going to forget this. We are going to fight against the police. But that does not mean that it is going to happen at the cost of diversion from the original movement of for justice for Rohit Vemmula. So Mr. Appa Rao Podile and all his political masters should hear this out, that we are not going to leave this struggle, and the stage to which they have taken this struggle, there is no coming back from this struggle, and now this struggle will only end with the end of this kind of injustice. And in fact, this struggle, as Prashant was saying and as Professor Ratnam was saying just before me, this struggle being part of the historic struggle for annihilation of caste is not going to end anytime soon. It is not going to end till caste is eradicated from this country. When we took up this struggle, when all of us became part of this struggle, none of us were under the impression that this is going to be an easy struggle. We all were prepared for a long battle. And that is what is going to happen. That is what is going to happen. One of the achievements that this struggle has already obtained, I don't know whether we are going to get all our demands, accepted. But one of the things that we have already obtained is that in this university right now, everyone stands exposed. All the masks have dropped. All of us standing here today know who is exactly who. No matter which ones of us teach Marx in our classrooms, which ones of us teach Ambedkar in our classrooms, which ones of us teach in our classrooms. We have seen what they actually are. And that has been one of the achievements already that this struggle has achieved. We will only build upon this struggle. And it is a collective responsibility of all of us to not let this memory die. This is an institutional memory, and we'll do whatever it takes to keep this memory alive. So Johar Rohit Vemmula!
Johar!
Kitne Rohit maroge? तुम कितने रोहित मारोगे?
हरदम से रोहित निकलेगा।
जोहार रोहित वेमुला।
जोहार
So I will not talk much because I'm sure all of our friends will narrate to you the incidents that happened that day. So I'll not repeat whatever you know did happen that day. And all of us were there. All of you were there. So everyone here knows what really happened. One of the things that I really wanted to mention first off is that. Please let us not, as a collective, as a struggle, as a movement, let us not turn this into a hero worship. None of us are heroes. None of us are heroes. Just like all of us were fighting this and are still fighting this here in this university, some of us from this entire movement were representing the struggle inside the jail. That is what we were doing. And I'm just happy that in the representation, there was some representation from the faculty members. There is also a message from the jail. All the prisoners that we have been interacting with, in fact, there is a lot to talk about the conditions of the prison. We'll do that soon. But for today, I'll just want to convey to you that all of the prisoners that we have been talking to the in the prison, and in fact, all of the lower level constables, by lower level, I mean in the hierarchy, in the jail hierarchy, the lower level constables, most of who come from Dalit, ST, SC, OBC, minority communities, all of them have sent you their greetings, and all of them have sent you their support. And they are the ones who told us that this is a joint struggle. They told us that the struggle that we are fighting here is not different from the struggle that they are fighting inside the jail. In fact, one of the narratives I wanted to share with you is that one constable, he in person told me that what you are saying is happening in your university, same thing is happening in our jail administration. The superintendent of the jail is a Red D. And what he has done is he has posted Red D's in all the high-level posts.
Tell us about it.
And in fact, he has also, in order to put his Red D henchmen in those higher-level ranks, he has transferred all the SCST jail authority people outside to some other place. I don't know where they are, but they have been transferred out of Chellapalli prison. So he was saying that don't think that what is happening in your university, there are some Kammas who are doing it, here there are some Reddies who are doing it. It's all part of the same design, it's all part of the same idea, it's all part of the same structure. So if you have to break this structure, we have to break it everywhere. And that is why these people are scared, because they have seen now that this struggle is not just a struggle of University of Hyderabad. This struggle is not just a struggle of the 5 suspended Dalit students. This struggle is not just the struggle of Rohit Vemula. This struggle is the struggle of the entire country, and it is a historic struggle. It is a historic struggle. And this country and these people like Mr. Apparao Kodili has never seen anything like this in their life. That is why they are scared. That is why he ran away from this campus. Again. One of the things that Professor Razlam did not mention because he is too humble is that he was targetedly picked up. Why was he targetedly picked up? It is because of, first of all, it's not just because he's a Dalit faculty member in this university. It's also because he's one of the founder members and the head of the Center for Ambedkar Studies. It is not a coincidence that the same power structure that targets Ambedkar Students Association also targets the Center for Ambedkar Studies. It cannot be a coincidence. It is not a coincidence that Dr. Ratnam, together with Bhujja Tarakam sir and two other scholars, recently wrote a book, recently co-authored a book, which criticized the RSS co-option of Babasaheb Ambedkar. It is not a coincidence that Dr. Ratnam was picked up immediately after he came back from Nagpur, where he gave a talk, a public talk against caste discrimination. None of these things are coincidences. He was targetedly picked up. Just like many of the students who were picked up, many of the students who were brutalized, many of the women students who were brutalized beyond description, who were brutalized to our, I had the shock of my life when I saw how our women students and our women faculty members, my department colleague, Professor Shobha, she was attacked. She is a senior faculty member. She's a senior woman faculty member. And she was brutally attacked by the police. So none of these things are coincidental. All of these things form part of the same design that these people have been trying to implement for ages. This is not new. None of this is new. This is what has been happening for thousands of years. And now these people are scared that their hegemony, their violence, their co-option, their coercion, all these things are being questioned. And they're being questioned not by a few individuals, they're being questioned by people at large. And that is what is at stake. And therefore, like Prashant said, once you are sent to jail, what is the next thing that can happen to you? What is the next worst thing that can happen to you? You can be killed. In the words of Rohit, you will be sent to the stars. Right? So it is true that if this struggle I mean, given the stakes that this struggle has, all of us are prepared to take it to the level of the stars. And we'll not stop before that. None of us are going to stop before that. And Mr. Podili should hear this out. I don't know if wherever he's hiding right now, if he's hearing this or not. He has blocked out the media. His university administration is not letting the media enter here. But I really hope that he hears this out clearly. We will take it to the stars and we'll not leave you. Or any of your political masters. Your ideas, what you're trying to do. We'll go to the fullest extent to ensure that your designs are spoiled. The only other thing that I wanted to mention, I'll not take too much time. The only other thing that I wanted to mention is that as a faculty member here, you know, I'm really proud to be a faculty member in University of Hyderabad. I'm really proud to be associated with students who are also our comrades. I mean, this is, if anyone has any sense of rationality, anyone has any sense of any kind of judgment, they would know that this is very special. This is extremely special. They would know that this cannot happen in a Gurukul. And this is a fight. What the fight that we are all part of is exactly the fight of preventing this from becoming into a Gurukul. So I'll end with that. The only thing, the only other thing that I wanted to say is that, like Prashant already pointed out, is that the situation of our universities and the situation of our prisons today are, you know, very interesting. On the one hand, when prisons are slowly getting converted into classrooms, I mean, what we saw every morning, the way people used to rush in the jail to read newspapers, the way we were given with magazines by our neighbors in the jail, Frontline, Billy Gazette, all kinds of Outlook, all these magazines, the kind of study materials that we were given, not by the jail authorities, but our neighbors in the jail. If you compare that with how our universities, our official universities are being converted into a prison, the entire picture will emerge before you. They are converting our universities into prisons, and the prisons are getting converted into universities. That is the state of higher education in this country. Those of us who are part of this movement, those of us who have been part of this struggle, there is this constant allegation that we are bringing bad name, we are defaming the university. I want to tell them that you don't know what you are talking about. Just like you don't have any idea of what it means to be a nation, just like you have no idea about what a nation is, just like you have no idea of what justice means, similarly you have no idea what a university means. And we'll teach you what a university means. Thank you.